Hey, so what's going on, guys? It's Monday. It's the next day right after LS Fest. You know, we do a lot of racing. As you, a lot of you know, Friday night our engine went down. We lost one of our heads, and we rebuilt it on site and had it ready to go first thing in the morning. So not only do we do a lot of our own engine stuff, but we work on trucks, we work on everything. So we try and do a lot of DIY stuff and help people out. So today we're going to be talking about Cummins engines and VGT turbos and actuators. So what the that stands for variable geometry turbo, and what that really means is it goes from a big to a small turbo, all right? And the way that happens is it's got an electronic actuator on it, and that's what we're gonna be replacing today. So we're gonna kind of show you how to do that. You have to have a scanner and Cummins software in order to program this thing. So you have to program it whenever you put it on. It's got a calibration tools and stuff of that nature, and we'll walk you through on all that. But the way that these things work is there's small fins inside the turbo, and they're actuated from this actuator. It runs off a gear. And whenever you're at low idle, you're sitting here at idle and stuff like that, you don't need boost, you know what I mean? So if you're just sitting there, you don't need any boost. So what happens is them fins inside the turbo, they close. Now let's say if I got a load on this thing, all right, and I want to take off and go up this hill, well, I need a small turbo to get immediate boost right away at low RPM. So these little fins inside the turbo, the actuator will close them, and it changes the housing size of the turbo and makes it small, which makes it spool really fast. Now as I start to gain more torque and mile per hour, etc., and I'm starting to go up the hill, now I need a bigger turbo because my turbo's winding out. So that actuator will slowly open up that vane, and it's changing the diameter of the turbo and making it bigger. That way I can run more boost off of it. So it's the best of both worlds. You know, you got small turbo power right out the pocket, no drag on it, it's boosting right away. And then whenever you're needing more power and you're up in RPMs and you're going down the highway and you need a big turbo to really pull this thing, it becomes a whole lot bigger. The problems with these things are just ungodly. So first and foremost, right now we're at a parts shortage in the world, so it's hard for us to get anything, but we do have an actuator for it. I have already checked the turbo vane on this thing. So the actuator has a gear on it that hooks to the turbo. And whenever you take this thing off, you need to move that gear back and forth to make sure it's not locked up. Because if it is locked up, then you're gonna have to replace the turbo. If it's not locked up and the actuator just went out, they burn up a lot more than the turbo does. And the reason why they burn up is because they're on the side of a turbo, and you know the turbo gets extremely hot. So we're putting a lot of heat towards a lot of electronics. Now they are protected, however, stuff still gets in there and destroys it. So we're gonna go ahead and replace this turbo actuator. First things first, we're gonna go ahead and remove some parts. We wanna go ahead and take the air intake off of it. So we're gonna go ahead and pull that, and then it's good to go ahead and pull this fender, all right? That way we can get to the bolts on the actuator itself without stripping them. They're an Allen head key, all right? So this is the actuator itself right here. So we're gonna go ahead and remove this fender and remove the air intake so we can access everything, and we'll get started and we'll get back to the video. Thanks. Hey guys, so we went ahead and pulled the VGT actuator off of it. So if you look down on the inside here, it has coolant that flows through this thing. So whenever you get ready to do this job, I forgot to mention, it's a good idea to go ahead and replace or drain the coolant, you know, so it's not shooting all over you. But anyways, it's got some, it's got a little gear down here, and this gear actuates back and forth, all right? This gear controls the turbo, all right? And we're gonna show you that right here. If you look, you're still gonna lose some coolant even when you take this thing apart, because it retains some just as such, but don't worry about that. But that's the gear right there. So whenever you go ahead and pull this thing, the first thing you wanna do is check the gear itself. And as you can see, its coolant's pretty hot. This truck was running, but this thing moves back and forth, all right? If it doesn't move when you try and move it, and even if you put a wrench on it or something and try and move it back and forth, that means that the turbo is destroyed, all right? So you're gonna have to replace the turbo. Even if the fins on the inside of the turbine spin freely and there's no issues with them, the whole nine yards. If that doesn't work, it's non-serviceable and you have to replace the turbo. All right, but everything's good on that. It's moving back and forth by hand freely. So what we have here, and this happens 9 times out of 10, is that the actuator, the electronic side fails on it. You start having glitches, it's going in and out, you know, yada, yada, yada. So we've got a new one for it. We're gonna go ahead and plug it in. Now, when we plug this thing in, we do not install it. We plug it in and just lay it right here next to the turbo. And then that's where the programming part comes in. I'm gonna go ahead and plug this thing in. We're gonna get the laptop hooked up and then we're gonna show you how to do that. See you in a minute. What's up, guys? So we went ahead and got the VGT actuator plugged in. It's not installed yet. So we have Cummins Insite loaded up right now on my laptop. It's plugged into the truck. We got the key on. So it's already connected. Once we go into fault codes, you can see that we have VGT controller, special instructions, turbocharger, aftertreatment. Aftertreatment things are going to be because of this turbo isn't working. You know, as far as the coolant level, that's because we drained the coolant level out of it. VGT actuator driver circuit, abnormal actuator software. Everything's messed up with this actuator. So we're going to go ahead and get out of fault codes. We're not going to worry about clearing any right now. We're going to go into Ecm Diagnostic Test. That's going to bring us a whole bunch of stuff up. And down here towards the bottom, we have VGT electronic actuator installation and calibration. We're going to go into that. First things first, you have to do the install first. You can't calibrate it until the install is performed. As you see, it said the VGT actuator must be removed from the turbocharger before proceeding with install. You will damage this thing if you do not. Go ahead and hit OK here, and we're going to go ahead and hit start. It's so significant about that, it goes ahead and shows you a warning again. Make sure it is not on the turbo when you do this. We're going to hit OK, and it's going to go ahead and run a test on it. It's pretty quick. That successfully passed. It can now be physically installed on the turbocharger. So we're going to do that right now and go on with the extra test. If you come over here, I'll go ahead and show you. Hey guys, we went ahead and got that actuator put on. So now we're going to go to the next procedure on the computer. So after install actuator, we're gonna go calibrate actuator. All right, it goes ahead and tells you that it needs to be on the turbocharger and the install must be performed first. Go ahead and hit start. It says the same thing again, second warning. Okay. All right, now this one's running. This one takes a little bit more time than the install process, but it went ahead and completed successfully. So right now, as of right now, it's virtually fixed. We need to go ahead and reinstall everything that we took off of it, and we're gonna go ahead and put coolant in it. Once we do all that, I will force a regen on this truck manually with this computer, clear out all the codes and stuff of that nature. Once that's done, the truck's ready to go. So that basically concludes it. I'll shoot a quick video of once we get everything put back together and coolant in it, I'll shoot a quick video of putting it in regen mode so we can show you how to do that and clearing everything out. That's basically it. It just fixed it. All right, guys, so we went ahead and put coolant in this thing, got everything reassembled on it. Now that we've done that, we want to come over here. I've got out of the diagnostic stuff, and I've went into our fault code section. Now, as you can see, everything except our after treatment codes have completely went active. Everything with the VGT, our pressure, you know, coolant level, the whole nine yards. So it basically fixed itself once we did all this. Now, as far as the after treatment, it threw those codes because the turbo wasn't able to put enough pressure back there to clean out the DPF system. So it's got that locked up right now. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and clear out everything. And you just right click on the screen, it'll say reset all faults. We're gonna go ahead and hit yes, reset all faults. It'll have you turn the key off. Click OK, and then it's going to go through its reset phase. So now that it's doing that, we're going to let it go ahead and go through its reset phase. That takes about 2 minutes. So once it resets itself, we're going to put the unit into a forced regen. Now, once it forced regens, these after treatment codes will go away. So they'll clear themselves out. So once we get this thing going, we can go ahead and hit that, and then we can get on the road and move to the next job.